Skin tags are very common, and according to the American Osteopathic College of Dermatology, almost half of all adults experience them. For the most part, they're painless, but how do you get rid of skin tags fast? Let's say if I'm looking at what I can do right now at home, well, I'll be sharing three ways that you could try now at home to see if they will work for you. You'll want to stay tuned till the end, as I'll also be revealing a bonus tip that could be a game changer when removing these skin tags, so definitely watch tune till the end. Hi guys, you've seen Arsenal Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. This channel is all about helping you make more informed decisions about your health and wellness. And if that's something you're into, take 2 seconds now to give this video a like to support my channel and subscribe down below to not miss out on future videos. It seriously makes my day and I love having you all here. So without further ado, before we get into the three remedies, let's start off with what are skin tags, and secondly, why do they form? Skin tags are known as acrochordons. They are small growths or flaps of tissue, and they stick out from the surface of the skin. They're usually the same color of your skin or slightly darker, and usually small, anywhere from 1 to 2 centimeters. But they can grow larger, and as long as you keep them away from any friction, let's say from clothing or jewelry, they shouldn't be painful. And I've seen them grow up to 5 centimeters as well, so it's important to make sure to keep friction low in these areas. And the most common areas you'll find them are eyelids and under the eye, underarms and in the armpits, under the breast, on the neck, and even in and around the groin area. But you might be curious to know, how on earth do these guys form and where do they come from? Well, there are a number of recognized causes. The first is being female. According to the Cleveland Clinic, skin tags occur more often in women than men, and they often appear at middle age and may be related to weight gain. Other causes can be aging in general, friction, which we talked about, genetics, and interestingly, certain endocrine and metabolic syndromes and hormonal imbalances. The common ones being diabetes and insulin resistance. And although they're harmless, and as harmless as they might be, skin tags can also be very annoying and can snag on your clothes sometimes. Also, you may want to remove them for cosmetic reasons too. So let's get to the first remedy you guys can try. Also guys, if you are enjoying the video, please give it a like down below. Now let's get straight back to the video. The first remedy is apple cider vinegar. And as you know, it's been used for generations for skincare because of its ability to fight harmful bacteria and fungi, balance pH levels, and more. So to start off with this, use the organic apple cider vinegar with the mother included. Soak it in a sterile cotton ball and secure it in place over the skin tag with a Band-Aid for 20 minutes. Then remove it and check for any irritation. And if there's no irritation, then you'll want to do the 20-minute treatment during the day and then before bed and leave it on overnight. I do not recommend doing this to tags closer to the eye. However, as you may get stinging and burning in the beginning, just something to keep in mind. In the beginning, it may get darker, meaning it's drying, and it may take a few days or even a couple of weeks to see the results. The second remedy is iodine, especially povidone iodine, which you can pick up at your local pharmacy. For this treatment, soak a Q-tip in iodine and spread the liquid across the tag and cover the area with the Band-Aid until the iodine has dried. And then you can repeat this treatment twice a day until the tag drops off. Now the thing with iodine, it works by breaking down skin cells, so avoid it on the healthy surrounding skin. And to be safe, carefully apply coconut oil to the 1/2 inch area around the skin tag to create a barrier. And the third remedy is garlic. Even though this is the smelliest option on this list, it still is worth trying, as garlic can be a powerful remedy. And this is because of the bioactive compound in garlic called allicin. This sulfurous compound in garlic has been studied for their ability to inhibit cancer cells and block tumor growth, which is why it has been used anecdotally as a method to removing skin tags. So to make sure to do this correctly, simply crush a large clove of garlic with a knife to release the potent oils and keep crushing it until it forms a smooth paste. Apply the paste on the tag and secure it with a Band-Aid over the skin tag and leave it on for about an hour. The next thing you want to do after it is wash it using mild soap and water. Now, since you made it this far, I'll be sharing with you guys that bonus tip that I think is worth trying as well, which is manuka honey. Now, Manuka honey is a type of honey that's native to New Zealand, and it's produced by bees who pollinate the flower Leptospermum scoparium, and Manuka honey's antibacterial properties are what set it apart from your normal traditional honey. And that's because it contains methylglyoxal as its active ingredient, giving it great antibacterial properties, which is why it got FDA approved for wound treatment. Also, Manuka honey is a non-peroxide type of honey, which helps the skin tag to dry off by restricting the supply of oxygen. So to do this correctly, soak a cotton ball in honey and apply it on the skin tag and secure it with a Band-Aid and leave it on for about 2 to 3 hours a day until the tag falls off. And if you've tried these methods in the past and have had no results, then the best way may be to get rid of them is to contact a medical professional to remove them by using techniques like cryotherapy or cauterization. Let me know what your thoughts are down below. I'd love to hear them. Also, please like the video if you did enjoy it and subscribe not to miss out on future videos. And also, turn that bell on so I could see you on the next one.